Talushi, you are listening on YouTube channel named Let's Listen Something. A certain priest's daughter went strolling in the forest one day, without having obtained leave from her father or her mother, and she disappeared utterly. 3 years went by. Now in the village in which her parents dwelt there lived a bold hunter, who went daily roaming through the thick woods with his dog and his gun. One day he was going through the forest, all of a sudden his dog began to bark, and the hair of its back bristled up. The sportsman looked, and saw lying in the woodland path before him a log, and on the log there sat a mujik plaiting a bast shoe. And as he plaited the shoe, he kept looking up at the moon, and saying with a menacing gesture, "Shine, shine, O bright moon!" The sportsman was astounded. "How comes it," thinks he, "that the mujik looks like that? He is still young, but his hair is gray as a badger's." He only thought these words, but the other replied, as if guessing what he meant, "Gray am I, being the devil's grandfather." Then the sportsman guessed that he had before him no mere mujik, but a leshy. He leveled his gun and bang! He let him have it right in the paunch. The leshy groaned, and seemed to be going to fall across the log, but directly afterwards he got up and dragged himself into the thickets. After him ran the dog in pursuit, and after the dog followed the sportsman. He walked and walked, and came to a hill. In that hill was a fissure, and in the fissure stood a hut. He entered the hut. There on a bench lay the leshy stone dead, and by his side a damsel, exclaiming, amid bitter tears, "Who now will give me to eat and to drink?" "Hail, fair maiden," says the hunter. "Tell me whence thou comest, and whose daughter thou art." "Ah, good youth, I know not that myself, any more than if I had never seen the free light, never known a father and mother." "Well, get ready as soon as you can. I will take you back to Holy Russia." So he took her away with him, and brought her out of the forest. And all the way he went along, he cut marks on the trees. Now this damsel had been carried off by the leshy, and had lived in his hut for 3 years. Her clothes were all worn out, or had got torn off her back, so that she was stark naked, but she wasn't a bit ashamed of that. When they reached the village, the sportsman began asking whether there was anyone there who had lost a girl. Up came the priest, and cried, "Why, that's my daughter." Up came running the priest's wife, and cried, "O thou dear child, where hast thou been so long? I had no hope of ever seeing thee again." But the girl gazed and just blinked with her eyes, understanding nothing. After a time, however, she began slowly to come back to her senses. Then the priest and his wife gave her in marriage to the hunter, and rewarded him with all sorts of good things. And they went in search of the hut in which she had lived while she was with the leshy. Long did they wander about the forest, but that hut they never found.